I love that. Also, let's talk about these apologies, because so many people are walking around waiting to heal, but they can't until somebody apologizes to them. Please talk to me from a psychotherapy standpoint about that, because I think so many of us really, really, really are walking around wanting those apologies and wanting people to say, I'm sorry, and I'm not going to heal until he or she realizes how they did me wrong.
Right, right. Well,
talk to me about that, because I want people to get free from that today.
You know, not just in intimate relationships, but even in with you know, adult, with parents. Yeah. There are people still waiting for their parents to say, I'm sorry, you know. And the bottom line is, I find that once that person says, I'm sorry, it doesn't change anything. It doesn't change what happened, because you can't go back and change that. And all it is an apology. Yeah. But you have to decide that you're ready to move past whatever it is. And so what I hear too is, I want that person to apologize, and I also want closure. See, girlfriend,
tell
you are
about
responsible
that word.
For
well, closure. Is this really, because some people are like, there's no such thing as closure.
Yeah, there is.
And so what is closure, Nettie?
You're intentional about saying, I'm going to wrap this up, put a bow on it, and put it on the shelf. Closure is something you do, not somebody else. Because I don't.
Yeah, something you know. That's good.
How can somebody close me? How can somebody wrap up my
y'all heard,
experience
how can somebody close
and
me?
What's been going on? And I have
nobody
to do
does. Okay, so Nettie just said that closure is something that you have to do. Nobody can give you closure. Like, how can someone close you up? Because again, we're always like, I want to get closure, and I need him to give me closure. He can't give it to you.
No.
So even if he never apologizes for what he did wrong, that closure is up to you. That healing is your responsibility.
Yeah, and absolutely. And this is the deal. If he doesn't apologize, that's on him. You
give
it back to him. That's where he is.
Mm-hmm.
It has nothing to do with you. And that's the part I think we keep asking. What's wrong with me?
Mm.
You know, well, maybe I need to do that. What did I do wrong? Why is it he treats me that way?
Mm.
He's not treating you that way. He's just being who he is. And you're affected by it. So that's why we're responsible for saying, you know what, this is uncomfortable for me. Then that means you need to move and position yourself to a more comfortable place.
I love that.
You have to do that, ladies.
I love that.
If we're waiting on them, we'll be waiting.
And so many times we're afraid, though. We don't want to be alone. We don't want to be single. We don't want to be that statistic. We don't want to be that person again. And it's like, but sometimes it's better for you to be alone and to let that mess go than it is for you to just stay on to
Well, you know what? Women say that all the time. I just don't want to be alone. And I'm thinking,
you're always
alone.
Yes, you're already alone. He's
words
not the
matter
one.
So much. Words matter so much. But the bottom line is, we're always alone. So what you want is somebody to come along with you. You want the companionship. That's what you want. You know, I think that is...